paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime, and bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go on, 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 on.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end.
We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions
of the world. I've taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race. Time after time, I've done my sentence, but committed no crime, and bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go home.
My bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise.
The sport of the wide or striving brings the out here. Nice grass. We don't need grass much anymore. They all dig it up. So this is a really nice traditional track. Motocross, that's what we used to do all the time. You know, it's really cool seeing Noisy and Neil Hudson and, you know, the Reeves of Van Bart with those guys. It's just a great bit of history for me to come back here and enjoy the full music. Strictly a hospice arm. Thank you. It's been 3 years. Back there in 2 weeks' time, that must serve as memory for you. 30 years, but it's I can't, it's amazing. It's been that long. I'm just happy I'm still riding. And it was real fun to be part of that historical moment. I got the chance to ride this track a couple years ago, and I don't remember it being that tough. But it's going to be a lot of work for the Americans this year, and it's always good to have good competition. The Americans always talk for us. But next up, well, you might want to get a picture of this, which you're not going to see very often. This man riding a red machine, that's for sure. Ladies and gentlemen, the man who has 19 World Veteran Championships under his belt, and he is Mr. Yamaha. Don't do that!
Yeah, thank you very much.
You got a call very late on to come over here, but you enjoyed yourself?
Absolutely, you know, just like Chuck said, it's great to see all these people just enjoying the bikes and such a great advantage to the track. It's got so much history, you know. I never got to ride many GP tracks in my days, you know. I've always been out here. I did a little longer national racing over here, but mostly Supercross. Whenever I came to Europe, I raced Supercross. So this is just such a great experience. The history here, you know, just
I know you were a factory rider, you did everything, but then you went on to development. Now, we talk about history. Do you feel a sense of pride that you really are part of history because you were the man who helped develop the first of the modern sport race?
Yeah, you know, that's something, much like Chuck said with his donations, it's something that I will carry a bit of honor all through the rest of my life. You know, when I first saw that project, I wasn't real sure, and I didn't have a lot of confidence in it, but, you know, about a year into it, you know, we were riding that bike about 3 years before anyone ever saw it. And, it's a part of history now. It's a part of my history program on the racetrack in modern racing.
For the man who holds records, he has 7 U.S. titles, 7 a record of motocross relations titles. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only legend, it is Jeff Ward. Jeff, you really have been there, done it, and got the t-shirt, because you've won everything in your day, and I'm so proud of you. But you're moving into a new phase now as a team owner, and a bit spooky, you were born in Scotland, and you just hired a rider who lives in America who was born in Scotland, is that right?
Yeah, Dean Wilson, so really excited to have Dino on board, and he's one of the up-and-coming kids coming up, so it should be fun, and it'd be great to be out there and have a chance to, you know, get on the podium with him and develop his career and hopefully help him out to get a bike there and get a team there. So it's lots of juggle, but I'm enjoying it.
Well, I'm sure you are, and we really appreciate you making the effort to come over. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff Ward. Now, we move on a couple of years, back a couple of years now, to a man who absolutely dominated when motocross was huge in America. Please welcome Mike Bell. Mike, you were in the really... Right, okay, now then, we've got to charge along, and, well, this man come over for a bit of fun at the weekend, but, well, you seem to be taking things a little bit serious over here. Ladies and gentlemen, the man who's really endeared us to all our hearts this weekend, the man who is having a fantastic time with it, please say hello to Ryan Hughes. Ryan, you're on a bit of a streak here.
Yeah, I guess. I'm just having fun, man, and when I have fun, I can ride a motorcycle pretty well, so, you know, I'm riding bikes that I haven't ridden ever and haven't ridden for a while, so it's really cool to get on some of these bikes, and, you know, the coolest thing is being lined up with all these guys, and I had every single one of these guys' posters on my wall, and I think I have even some of their jerseys and pants at my house, so it's really an honor to be in the same line as these guys. It almost feels like I shouldn't be here, but, you know, I got picked here, and, you know, if there's a race, you know, I give everything I have, and no matter what it is. If we're going to race across the parking lot, I'm going to beat you, so please try. But no, I'm having a blast, and everybody, every time I go around the track, everybody's cheering me on and stuff, so that just makes me push this thing a little bit harder, and that's racing, that's fun.
Well, we've loved having you here, but I mean, this event is just massive, and to be honest, everyone who's been here is going to come again, I'm sure, and they're going to tell everyone how good it is. Are you going to come back again?
Yeah, I'm already, I told them that I'm coming as long as they want me, and so I'll be here next year. As long as my hands and my arms heal up by next year, I'll be back. But no, this is definitely an honor, and again, like I was saying last night, we're veterans, but hey, we still, you know, it's still an honor to be on part of the team and be recognized as that, be able to put a show on for people and not be on the couch watching NASCAR and drinking beer and being fat. So it's a cool honor, so it's good.
Just very quickly, though, I did hear from a reliable source that you're gradually going back to the settings that you had on the last time you rode this bike in the 80s. Is that right?
Yeah, because we came over here and the settings were what I had when I rode the Nation since Slovakia in 95, but I haven't ridden the bike since, so I jumped on it and I'm like, what the heck is this? You know, because I'm so used to my four stroke. So I thought, well, maybe I just don't know what I'm talking about back then. So I adjusted some things and it wasn't 2.0. So now we've gone back to what I had back then, and I think we'll be making it better. And I'm starting to feel a little bit more comfortable on it. And I have two more races, so we'll see how it goes.
So you'll get it right by the end of the day. ladies and gentlemen, the winningest rider here on the weekend, Ryan Hughes. Now I've been told to hurry up, but I don't care. I'm just like a kid in a street shop talking to people here, so we're going to carry on. Talk about legends, ladies and gentlemen. This name is right up there with everybody. The one, the only, Ronnie Lachine. Ryan, well, your weekend has been very different. Should we say that?
Yeah, it's a couple unfortunate incidents for me. As soon as I took the track for qualifying yesterday, I had a little incident over in the mud pit. You know, bent the shift lever on the bike, and so all of qualifying practice, I was stuck in second gear. So I figured I better get a time on there to try to get some kind of a spot on the gate. And so we did all right, and you know, they put a new shifter on the bike for the race, and you know, I took off, and you know, the bike was shifting fine for a few turns, but somehow the shifter spun on the spline, and the bike was stuck in first gear. And when I went to the line, you know, I saw Jeff Ward. You know,
say hello and show your love and appreciation for the whole team, including Paul Ronnie.
Neil.
What on, Neil?
She ran away in her sleep.